For the first time ever, a generation of kids is going through their entire adolescence with a smartphone in their hands. A Minnesota-born professor has dubbed these kids the iGen generation. They were born after 1995.
And while this screen time has ultimately led to some safer behaviors, her research found it's making kids unhappy. So much so, she says, this new generation is at the brink of the worst mental health crisis in decades.
We now hold the hindsight. The advent of the smartphone changed an entire generation with a swipe.
The rumors are true. We're all addicted to our phone.
Teens who've only known the world with and through a screen.
I was 10 years old and I had the T-Mobile Sidekick.
One of the best things of our generation. We have the ultimate tool to stay connected.
So what year were you born?
1997.
So I call them iGen. They're born between 1995 and 2012.
Dr. Jean Twenge, a San Diego State University psychology professor and Minnesota native, coined that term after studying surveys of 11 million teens and young adults.
Right around 2011 and 2012, I started to see some big and pretty sudden changes among teens and realized this might be the advent of a new generation. I interviewed 23 teens from around the country, including two in Minnesota, and kind of found out, you know, how they spend their lives and how different that is from what their parents experienced.
And what she found changed her view of screen time for her own three kids.
I really did this. I got up from my desk, took my kids' Kindle Fires that they used to watch videos, and put them away in a desk drawer.
Research and advice now detailed in the soon-to-be-released book, iGen.
Why today's super-connected kids are growing up less rebellious, more tolerant, less happy, and completely unprepared for adulthood.
First, the good stuff. iGen kids are physically safer than those before them and put off risky behaviors by drinking less, driving later, even delaying sex.
That means, well, maybe you don't have to go out with your friends and thus, you know, have sex and drink because the party is on Snapchat, so you can just stay at home.
A generation more protected, but with a trade-off in the glow of that screen.
There's that cost of comparison and feelings of inadequacy.
Certainly, that's certainly part of it. You know, social media, people tend to post the positive thing.
But worse, the isolation, a pattern of loneliness.
It's cutting off this face-to-face interaction, which is so good for mental health happiness. Compared to teens just 5 or 10 years ago, iGen teens are more depressed, more anxious, and at higher risk for suicide. So we need to listen.
What is the solution? Dr. Twenge says first, spending more time with friends in person.
And sure enough, this iGen also does that less. And seeing friends in person, that's one of the best ways to increase happiness.
And parents play a big role. Her advice? Put off the purchase of that smartphone.
Until, say, high school might be a good idea. The mental health effects are the largest for the 8th graders in the survey and the smallest for the 12th graders. Teens are telling us that they're suffering, and we really need to listen to them and take that seriously.
All right, well, Dr. Twenge, you told me, say, if your kid needs a phone for riding the bus or keeping track of them at school, right, you can get them a flip phone, which, of course, no kid wants a flip phone.
Right.
It's kind of controversial until they're old enough. And she said that she interviewed a mom here in Maple Grove, and that mom told her that she uses these apps on her kids' smartphones that limit the time and shut them off when appropriate and shut them off overnight. So there's an idea that's on the market, too.
I think the problem is you have to get a whole generation of parents to get on board with this, because it's hard to give your kid a flip phone if everyone else has an iPhone, right?
Yeah.
And so you have to also... There's all these studies coming out saying it's just not good for their little brains. So you have to get a whole generation of parents to say, you know what, it's not making my kid smarter, faster, bigger, stronger, so maybe we should back off of it. But it's so hard to be that parent that's the only one doing it.
Right, and then do as I say, but not as I do. So here we are on our
right.
phones. We have to look at our own behaviors and how they are mirroring
our life. I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, my baby knows what a phone is, if that says something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, goodness gracious. All right.